What is your definition of a hedge fund, short explanation on short selling, and how the tools of modern finance are managing the downside risk while actively seeking alpha?
Okay, well, in the fixed interest sphere, the hedge fund is generally defined in terms of its leverage. So the Southeastern Fund happens to be 12 times geared. How one generally achieves that is through buying assets and then borrowing the funds to finance those assets, and then also often to hedge out certain risks that one doesn't want to take, directional risks of the bond market, for example. You would short sell bonds to hedge those risks, and then you'd have to borrow the scrip to deliver on those short sales. So generally, it's the leverage is the key determinant of the risk. There are various ways to define that leverage. In our case, we use a concept called rand per point. So a long dated 30-year bond has a higher rand per point, which is a measure of risk. So the sensitivity in price to a 1 basis point change in yield is your rand per point risk. And a short dated bond has a very low rand per point risk. So a 2-year bond is nowhere near as risky as a 30-year bond. There are other measures of risk that govern a fixed interest hedge fund. So a measure commonly used is value at risk. So a 1% value at risk 1-day limit determines how much a fund is expected to lose 1 day in 100. And our 1% 1-day VaR limit is set at 6%. So 1 day in 100, the fund might lose more than 6%, but generally no more. And that's quite an extreme event that needs to happen for that to occur. And then there are various other measures of risk, but those are quite technical, so I don't need to go into those. What we can discuss perhaps is how one achieves that leverage that I spoke about earlier. And typically if one goes long, so think of it as simplistically, if you have a 50 million rand fund and you buy 50 million rands worth of the R186 government bond, that could give you 1x geared. And if to get 2x geared, you buy another 50 million. But you don't own that 50 million, you need to borrow the funds to do that. And a common tool to do that is the repo market. So typically what you would do, it's a sale and a buyback. So let's say you've bought your extra 50 million, which takes you to 2x geared, and then you sell the 50 and buy it back 1 week later, which is effectively the same as borrowing 50 million rand. And those transactions trade on a weekly basis in the South African bond market and at an interest rate. And you're probably familiar with the repo rate that the South African Reserve Bank set at their bi-monthly meetings. And that repo rate determines the borrowing costs in the repo market. Then let's say you decided to hedge out the interest rate risk on the two clips of 50 million that you've bought. So you then sell 100 million rand of a bond called the R209, which is a 2036 government bond. You've now shorted those bonds. You've taken out your directional risk. Simplistically, you've taken your leverage from 2x geared to 4x geared. And what you then need to do, because you don't have the bonds that you've sold, is you then do a reverse repo. So you go to a bank, all the big banks offer these transactions, and you would buy the 50 million bonds that you've sold, and then you'd sell them back a week later. So you remain short and you've effectively borrowed the scrip. So for equity funds, you often have scrip lending transactions where individuals will short sell a share and they just borrow the paper. In the bond market, we tend to do it through a repo. Other ways of ensuring leverage are through interest rate swaps. Those are interest rate derivatives, and you can trade in a 10-year interest rate swap or a 30-year interest rate swap. It's the same as buying a bond if you receive a swap, or if you pay a swap, it's the same as selling a bond. And those also hedge out risk, but you can use them to take additional risk depending on your view. So in a nutshell, those are the tools that we use to create leverage, which is the key differentiator of a hedge fund compared to, say, a long-only fund.